prices.
A man was on his way from Jerusalem to Jericho when he fell in among robbers who beat him and stripped him and left, leaving him half dead. It so happened that a priest was making the journey as well, and when he saw him...
And pray for your persecutors.
You don't mean?
Yeah, I do. Only so can you be called children of your heavenly Father, who sets his sun on the good and bad alike and sends the rain on the honest and the dishonest. Now, if you greet only those who greet you, what reward can you expect in that? Surely the tax gatherers do as much. And if you love only those who love you, what is there extraordinary in that? Even the heathen do as much. No, your goodness must know no bounds, just as your heavenly Father's goodness knows no limits. But be careful not to make a show of your religion before men. Because if you do, no reward waits for you in the kingdom of heaven. When you do some act of charity, don't announce it with a flourish of trumpets as the heathen do in the synagogues and in the streets. I tell you, they do it only for the admiration of men. No, when you do some act of charity, don't let your right hand know what your left hand is. Your good deed must be in secret.
Shh, it's a secret, okay?
What the good master is telling us is that heaven is like a bowling alley with a big, fat, greasy angel named Bubba. Resides over all the lanes, and suppose if you get a strike, that would be the equivalent of helping, oh, maybe 20 old women across the street. Or maybe a spare would be like donating some clothes to your local homeless drive. No?
No. Your heavenly Father, who sees what is done in secret, he will what?
Reward you!
Yeah.
Rich man who dressed in purple and the finest linen.
That's me.
And every day feasted in the greatest magnificence. At his gates lay a poor man. Named Lazarus. Would have been glad to have satisfied his hunger with the scraps from the rich man's table.
Oh my God, it's good.
Even the doggies used to lick his open, running, swords! Yeah. Well, one day the poor man died. And was carried away by the angels.
Thank you.
man also died.
And was buried in Hades, where he was in torment.
Yeah.
where I meant you. Put away anxious thoughts about food and clothes. Surely life is more than food, and the body more than clothes.
She's more than clothes! Look, I'll show you!
Consider the lilies of the field. They don't work and they don't spin. Yet I tell you, Solomon in all his splendor was never attired like one of these. So if that's how God treats the grasses that are here today and are thrown onto the fire tomorrow, will he not all the more clothe you? How little faith you have. So don't go around saying, what am I to eat? What am I to drink?
But what are we to eat?
Set your mind where? So don't go around wondering about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Each day has problems of its own.
Oh, problems.
Blessed are the poor in spirit,
for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are they that mourn,
for they shall be comforted.
Blessed are the meek,
for they shall inherit the earth.
Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for justice,
for they shall be filled.
Blessed are the merciful,
for they shall have mercy.
Blessed are the poor in heart,
for they shall see God.
Blessed are the peacemakers,
for they shall be called the children of God.
Blessed are they who are persecuted for righteousness,
for theirs is the kingdom of God.
Blessed are those who may revile you and persecute you and say all manner of things against you. Falsely.
Did I ever tell you I used to read feet? Yeah, some people read palms and tea leaves. I used to read feet. Yeah, come here. It says rejoice.
It says Reebok.
Yes, rejoice, for great is your reward in heaven.
When you feel sad or under a curse, your life is bad. Your prospects are worse. Your wife is sighing, crying, and your olive tree is dying. Temples are graying and teeth are decaying and creditors weighing your purse. Your mood and your
not that you yourself should not be judged. Whatever you do off to others.
Attention!